Ready to match the stars, Richard Deacon. Brett Summers. From the Love Boat, Fred Grundy. From Ladies' Man, Louise Sorrell. Bill Daly. And from Flo, George Beulevant. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reddick.
Thank you, John. Thank you, friends. I brought my own today. Thank you, all right. Well, I'll use yours, John, if you want me to. Throw it in here, that a boy. You know the tradition here. When we have a new kid on the block, we have to welcome that person properly.
Oh.
And we don't want to offend at any time.
Yeah. Hey, Chris is great. I really like this. I remember when I was new. It was really
nice. I think she's going to be wonderful on the show, and we're going to have her back over and over and over again and pretend it's the first time every time. Welcome, Louise.
Thank you.
Now let's all welcome Ross Birdsall and Jan Zebley. Now let's get acquainted with the two of you here. Jan, we'll begin with you. Anything you want to tell us about yourself?
I'm from Roseville, California, which is up near Sacramento. I have a son that's 13 months, and I'm married. Good thing. And I'm a dental hygienist. And you have nice teeth.
Thank you. Tell the world they're mine.
Oh, they're beautiful. They're all his.
Okay. Thank you, Jan. Thank you. Ross, what about you, sir?
Well, I'm an associate development engineer at UCLA Laboratory of Nuclear Medicine, the biomedical cyclotron there. And I have four children, live in Fullerton, California. I love backpacking, and I do occasional jogging.
Where do you backpack?
Well, I generally up in the Sierras. We were up there about 2 weeks ago or so, and above Rock Creek Lake. Just beautiful country. Did some fishing.
Yep.
Just outstanding.
Nature is wonderful.
Oh, it's beautiful. Just.
But you scientists aren't going to screw up the world with your
nuclear stuff. I hope not. I hope not.
Okay. All right. Here we go. Game one, round one. Jan, A or B?
A, please.
A it is. Here we go. At the antique shop, Ralph said, "This piece of sheet music has got to be fake. Who ever heard of a disco song written by blank?" Do you understand?
I got that. Gotcha.
All right. You what?
Very low.
You're very low? What can we do to get her high?
No,
I'm in a boozer. I'm gonna get this.
Oh, wait a minute.
Tina.
She meant low down.
Oh, your chair is low. Would you change seats with her? You're taller than she is.
All right, just take a seat.
No, let's see. Let's move this one over there.
I got off the train backwards once because I heard a guy was going to grab my seat.
Wait a minute. This is too high. Let's move this up there.
All right, let's get it out here. Yes, right. All right. There we go, Jim. At the antique shop, Ralph said, "This piece of sheet music has got to be fake. Who ever heard of a disco song written by blank?"
Beethoven.
Beethoven. Now, why would anyone say Beethoven over Mozart or Bach or Brahms or any of the others?
Well, probably because they're intelligent.
Beethoven. Right. What'd you say?
I didn't say Beethoven, and I didn't say Mozart, and I didn't say any of those
things.
What
did you say?
I said Mr. Johann Sebastian Bach.
Right. He would be more generic, I believe. He created...
did a lot of fugues.
Beethoven wrote that stuff after he was deaf, so he wouldn't have to listen to it. Uh-huh.
What was Bach famous for?
Fuguing. He better wrote a lot of fugues.
Right, all right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I agree with you.
This piece of sheet. 1 to 5, what do you think?
Minus four!
Something along these lines.
This piece of sheet music has got to be fake. Whoever had heard of a disco song written by?
Same as Brett.
Bach.
Sorry. All right. cue Beethoven.
Why is that a bad answer? Because he's older. You said very old and antique. I'm sorry. I like to have my chair, Bob. What is this chair? Bob, I'm sorry, another Bob. What happened? This chair is weird.
It's a chair.
We can fix it.
Did it just unscrew from the bottom or something?
Yeah, let's fix it. Let's get it up there.
This is really boring.
Can't we unscrew this chair with a gold wire?
My life is really boring. This is more boring than my life.
No, let's get the chair higher. Fix it. Unscrew the chair.
Can we put this down? Let's just bring this down a little farther.
Sit down and shut up.
I am sitting down. I'm standing. That's how low this chair is.
Let's see. Yes. Oh, we're finished.
We're calling Joyce.
She's the last one. Piece of sheet music got to be fake. Who ever heard of a disco song written by
Brahms?
All everything. Thank you very much. All right.
Oh, look at this.
Yes. Don't hurt her.
Don't hurt her back.
That's
her.
I wish this bit had never started.
Good.
I don't like this.
All right. All right. Are you ready? Here we go.
Is this masquerade?
No. Sid said I'm going to sell my car and start walking. So I bought the only pair of shoes in the world equipped with a blank. Good.
Thank you.
Good. All right. Sell my car, start walking, so I bought the only pair of shoes in the world equipped with a
pair of roller skates.
First thing that came to his mind. What's the first thing that came to your mind? Wheels? What, a pair of shoes with wheels? Well, that's roller skates. Dingbats? What do you say?
I said headlights.
Headlights.
No, that's logical. Come on.
Perfectly all right. What do you say, Brad?
What do I say? Yes. I want out of here. I want out of here now. I can go have a better time at Camarillo State Hospital. On the fifth floor.
Is it ladies' day?
I said a very small engine.
A very small engine, all right.
It's got a 380 horsepower engine.
A 380 horsepower engine. All right, the only pair of shoes in the world equipped with a...
an air conditioner.
An air conditioner, right. You need it there. All right.
A spare tire.
A spare tire.
Better than a pool.
Right. A pair of roller skates is what we're after here.
You are?
Yep.
I don't got it. I have an engine.
Engine. All right. So there's round one. Jams ahead. 2-0. Round two coming up in a moment. Now this for you. Here we go. All right. Round two coming up. And Jan, since you're ahead, you go first.
A, please.
Four people play. Brett in the lower tier. Harvey is the world's strangest dresser. Who asked you? I'll tell you when. Today, he's wearing one blue sock and one green sock. What's strange is, he's wearing them on his blank. All right. Harvey is the world's strangest dresser, Jan. Today, he's wearing one blue sock and one green sock. What's strange is, he's wearing them on his...
ears.
Ears. Ears. Now she's up to three. Louise, what finally came to your mind? You had a little trouble thinking about it.
My little mind?
Yes.
Fern.
Fern. That's right. That
makes no sense whatsoever.
Well, that's what you say when you can't think of an answer. Now, you can't boo a pretty girl like that. Yeah. You really can't. Unless you're booing his answer in advance, because you know it's going to be so dreadful.
What?
The ears have it.
The ears have it. All right. Here is Ross Birdsall, probably the smartest guy within a radius of 20 miles, being beaten by Jan Zebley here. So far. Now, Ross, you could tie it with 5 or win it with 6.
Okay.
At the racetrack, Martha said, "This weather is really terrible." I'm going to tell you, we've had so much rain, the jockeys are riding blank. That's how terrible the weather is.
But I see that myself.
At the racetrack, Martha said, "This weather is really terrible. We've had so much rain, the jockeys are riding blanks."
Water skis.
Water skis. That's an interesting sight. The horses are pulling them along on the water skis.
As one hairless man to another, I said rafts.
Rafts. Got to match everybody else, Ross. Let's see what you have, Brett.
Well, you see, I started to say side saddle. But I figured that wasn't going to make a bit of sense.
No, has nothing to do with the rain.
No. I said rowboats.
Rowboats. All right. So that means Jan wins the game. What the rest of you? Hold up your cards. Ducks. Yes. Game number 2. All right, okay. Spin them off here. And we'll see how Jan does with the big money. You got a lot of rooters out there? Who'd you bring?
My brother, my sister-in-law, and a couple friends.
They're all here, huh?
Yeah.
They're the one going, woo-hoo.
Yes.
Got a bunch of woo-hooers in your family.
Don't be crazy.
All right, Jan, we polled a studio audience not too long ago and said write down your best answer to this. Blank lemon.
Oh, sure.
$500 for the most popular answer. $250 for matching the second most popular answer, and then we give you $100 if you match the third. Whom do you call on for a little help here?
Brett.
Oh, the cutest little actor in town, Jack Lemmon.
All right, there's one.
Brett.
These are verbal. You don't put them in the thing there.
How about Bitter Lemon?
Bitter Lemon. Yeah. Could tell what kind of a drinker he is. Yes, Joyce?
Sour Lemon.
Yeah. Bitter Lemon, Sour Lemon, and Jack Lemon. You want one of those or one of your own?
I think I'm going to go with one of them. I'll go with Brett. Jack.
Jack Lemon. All right. We've got a Jack Lemon. Let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Meadowlark Lemon. Famous player with the Harlem Globetrotters. You know? Bum, 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 bum. Sweet Georgia Brown. Thank you very much for the background music. Now, let's take a look at the $250 response. Jack Lemon it is.
Well, I thought that was going to be on top.
I'll bet you are. Okay, slide the big one. Jan, you're still going to be playing for a minimum of $2,500, maybe $5,000. We'll find out which it will be right after we find out about this. Jan's won the $250. That means at least she'll play for us $2,500. However, we do want her to spin the wheel and see if she can double it up and play instead for $5,000. Good luck, and here we go, and see if she gets a double. You're playing for a double for $5,000 with Fred Dandy. Who?
And his brother,
Brandy. Oh, Brandy.
If I'm matching my last name,
it
might be a friend.
All right, here it is. Blank lobster. No help, please, because your answer may be the wrong answer, and you could lead her astray.
How much time have I got, Gene? Oh.
That's about it. All right, he's ready. Now, if you give us the answer that he's written on the card, we give you $5,000. What do you say to that?
Steak and?
Steak and lobster. Your brother is the only one clapping. Fred, she said steak and lobster to match you.
Yeah, well, I'm from New England, and I always took my lobster boiled.
Boiled lobster.
Boiled? Sorry.
Boiled lobster. Boiled? That's the traditional way of cooking a lobster. Boiled. That's a traditional way of cooking a lobster. Boiled. What? Boiled.
What?
Boiled. Rock lobster?
You ever
hear of a rock lobster?
No.
What is he, some kind of rock star?
What? Oh, punk rock. Oh. We're dealing with a bunch of weirdos here today, aren't we? All right. Now, Jam, we're going to bring your opponent back here and play game number two. So let's welcome back. Hey, Ross. She's got a total of $250. And we're ready to start the second and final game if you are, sir. You may go first with A or B.
B, please.
B it is. B says, Bart said, times have really changed. I went into a pet shop to buy a parrot, but instead of saying Polly wants a cracker, that bird said Polly wants a blank. Times have really changed. You want him to be a female? You want him to be a female? Sure, then he's a female. Ready up here? Times have really changed. I went into a pet shop to buy a parrot, but instead of saying Polly wants a cracker, that bird said Polly wants a blank.
A pizza.
A pizza. Very good, Ross. Cute answer, huh?
Uh-huh. I don't think he's as up to date as he should be. Hit or joint.
Oh, yeah. What do you say?
Shh.
Yes?
Pizza?
Pizza.
Shoot us a button, but boy, you're a loser here today, Roy. Joint!
I don't like those responses.
I just wonder, are these two people, the deans of show business, doing dope jokes on TV?
Right.
How about a sauna and a massage?
All right.
Is that cute?
Polly wants a sauna and a massage there. Louise, what do you want?
Well, I'm back in the 50s. A drink.
A drink. Okay. Billy Boy?
I would like my funny chair back, please. This is a Rye Crisp. Now, don't give me a good
Rye Crisp.
Booby!
Okay.
You're right. You're very intelligent. Good audience.
Yes, Miss Joyce.
I said, Polly wants another bird.
Well, all right, Jan, we'll have a question for you in a moment or so, but right now we have this for you, America. Right? You were all splendid. I thought she did quite well for
you were
her
splendid.
First day.
I thought she was adorable.
Wasn't she grand?
I thought
right.
It was hog heaven.
Very
yes.
Nice.
What is the name of the show that you're going to be doing?
Ladies' Man.
Ladies' Man. And it's Betty Kennedy's on it, right?
Betty Kennedy is on it.
And who else?
And Simone Griffith and Lawrence Pressman and Karen Morrow.
Oh.
And Natasha Ryan.
Oh.
And
all those ladies.
All those ladies.
Wonderful.
I love Karen Morrow.
Yes, yeah. They're all great. All right, we'll be here tomorrow for Match Game, and I hope you will be too. I'm Gene Rayburn. Thank you. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are The Allure Color Ensemble by Barclay Home Products for today's exciting fashion colors, filled with Acton Polyester Allure by Barclay. And an assortment of Anlon clothing. Quality and value never look so good. Quality and dress, quality and environment with Anlon. 4 gallons of super scrubbable two-test easy carry latex flat wall and trim finish, perfect for walls. Woodwork sold only by True Value Hardware Stores. And a deep fryer and spoon and fry donut mix. Make delicious hot donut holes in minutes. Add water to golden dips. New spoon and fry donut mix. Great family fun. And silver plated salt and pepper shakers. And the only solution conditioner. Adds luster and softness to your hair so gently you can use it on your skin. The only solution. And a baby bath and changing pad by Diaperine Baby Washcloths. Moisture packed towels, flannelin. The clean and condition keep your baby better than clean with Diaperine. And a bread tray, butter dish like Mads the Manicure says, try my palm olive dishwashing liquid. Palm olive softens hands while you do dishes.